I think we're ready. Oh my gosh. Okay. I think I got everything. Gas, water. So that was a short, very short little part of Moab, but I gotta get out of town. It's 101. I have gotten an incredibly late start. Well, apparently we're going to be routed through I've got the name of the place. I will put it up there. Sand. Been here a couple times. I didn't know I would get routed through. I should have realized. This is Transamerica Trail coming through here. Slick rock. Look how far we climbed. That was Sand Flats. I couldn't think of the name of it. Coming out of Sand Flats, about 15 miles, maybe 12 miles up, you get off into this double track that is not technical, but it sure was a challenge. It made me huff and puff. And it comes up to this road here. And I will continue this road till I get to this cutoff, heading somewhere up there. We'll see how that goes. But basically, it does a big loop and it ends up at Green River. So that's the deal. Wow, check out the view. Isn't that gorgeous? Oh, man, it's so pretty up here. And it is comfortable. It's probably, I don't know, lower 80s. But compared to what it was down there, that's pretty nice. But climbing, oh my gosh. Going up and up and up. About the crest up there. And then I started coming back down this way. And it looks like it's going to go up and down, up and down. But man, we're up there pretty high. You know what happens is you come off like a main road, and then it goes into a smaller asphalt road, and it goes into a wide graded road, and then it goes into this. So should I just think that I'm going to be into an even smaller trail? Yeah, it's funny, them guys down there at Mad Bro, they, as soon as I walked up, they all remembered me. It's been 2 years. Good bunch of guys. Now, when I get into areas like this, as you can see, there's the trees make it sunlight shade. And you guys that ride, you know what I'm talking about, because it really screws up your vision. But it's getting into that time of day where if I do start heading west, I get that sunlight right in my eyes, and that's another one. Man, when you're riding dead into the sun, oh geez. Okay, couldn't pass up a cliff. Couldn't pass it up to come look at it. That's a drop off, guys. I'm not even going to go any further than this because my clumsy feet. I remember I had the same issue back there when I was at Schaefer Trail, man. I'm not a daredevil. I fall down too much. That would kill me. That's a long way down. And I don't feel like ending my life right now. Later on in the trip, but not now. This is gorgeous. Just beautiful. And if you notice up there, well, let's see. Way back there where the snow is. I got some clouds up there. They're not serious clouds, but this is the first kind of dark clouds I've seen on the whole trip. And actually, I'm okay with it. I think it's just because the mountains draw it in. And so I come down a lot. Elevation. I'm not quite sure what's going to happen here, where I'm going, but I don't want to stop early. I want to ride and get some miles, but I'm not sure if it's going to take me back down in the heat. Wow, this is crazy. Be a cool place to get the drone out. You know, I haven't flown the drone yet at all. I could just dip it down in this canyon and this wind can just blow it into a wall. And I did that in a cave series. I ran, my drone was due. It was like, I didn't know what I was doing. I get up there and I go, because if you're facing, the front of the drone is facing away from you, your left is, or right is right, left is left. But when it's coming at you, it flops, and I wasn't used to it. So I wanted to go left and I went right, and it's like, oh crap. Hey, as long as I don't ride my bike like I fly my drone. Okay, onward, I guess. a steep grade here. Any of you guys watch much of this on YouTube, you know these grades don't look as steep as they really are. The appearance isn't, but when you're out here, they're pretty steep. The steepest grade I think I did was on the Transamerica Trail 2020. Going west to east, I think Ephraim, before I got to Ephraim, I don't know what part that was, but man, that road was incredibly steep, and it was a hard-packed road with a lot of loose sand on it, and I remember my rear of my bike would slide around and try to get in front of me. Yeah, we're going to start going in, riding into the sunlight. That's what I was talking about earlier, and I hate that. It's like that climb I just did to the gate. That was intensely steep. I had to get a running start and keep it under power because there's no way I was going to be able to stop and start again. And not knowing what's out in front of you, you just, you just go, man. Ooh, a stream crossing. Going through a canyon. Well, I was going to camp back there, but man, it's just, I'm having fun and yeah, I'm making pretty good progress now. I'm not tired. It's because I laid around there all day at Mad Bros and lounged in the shade and now I feel like riding and I got plenty of sunlight. Oh, it's a beautiful canyon. Oh, this is nice. Oh, look at the stream. Ooh, makes me want to go over there and get a drink. And I suppose I should have prepared and bought something to filter water because I got plenty. I mean, there's no issues there. But hey. Delay. Hey. Okay, let's go. Might as well do a scenic video Looks like it's going to be a cool canyon. So I obviously go up in elevation, and it was quite comfortable. And now obviously I've come back down, and it's getting hot. I have a feeling it's just gonna, the heat's gonna keep up for, I hope I don't have this kind of heat in Wyoming. It's gonna be interesting to see how this ride progresses. Oh, looky here, we do have a stream crossing. Not much of one, but I remember coming downhill in Nevada off this mountain, and the stream, yeah, same thing. The stream would, yeah, it's doing it too. It just goes, it goes back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And you just keep, you just keep crossing the same stream. Yeah, it does it again. So when I cross these streams, I don't cross towards the middle. What I mean by that is I try to stay where there's four-wheel drives and vehicles go through them. It's going to be the flattest, and so I don't split the difference. They just keep coming. I just keep taking the shortcuts there. I should have counted them. I'll have to go back when I edit and count them. Got a feeling we're gonna hit it again. So I have not seen anybody on the UTBDR, not one soul out here. I didn't see anybody on the Arizona BDR except for on the Indian reservation. There was a guy in a car, of all things. But I don't know what the deal is, man. Aren't you guys out riding? What's going on? Guys are probably out there in South Dakota or something doing them rides. You know, way up there by Canada. I sure haven't seen nobody down here. But I, recommendations for this stuff, guys, do it with somebody if you can. I mean, I shouldn't be doing this solo. At least, not at my age. I mean, come on. And, you know, make sure you bring a satellite, which I don't have one. I'll tell you what, if I go down, I'll just let you guys know, and you guys come out and get me, okay? But yeah, I would not recommend doing it alone. Some of you guys are so good at this stuff, though. I mean, I get it. I'm speaking from a mediocre writing ability and a handicap age limit. I know there's some guys out there that can eat this stuff up with no problem. I'm not one of them. I don't know what that white stuff is. It's not snow. It's some kind of a... something out of the soil. Hey, what am I doing in first? Come on. Here it is again. There's that sun. You know, it's like you squint your eyes and hit the throttle and hope for the best. But, you know, I travel all the time by myself. In a way, I like it, like on the Transamerica Trail, because that's a relatively safe environment. I mean, I know it's got some risk, and you could be out there and all that stuff. I mean, it does have some difficulty levels in some areas. We spoke about this before, you know, some of these BDRs, man, I just think they're a little bit tougher, and they're... some of them are quite a bit tougher and more desolate. That's my opinion. Guys, man, it's just me. Well, we can keep riding like this for quite a ways. It looks like we got some more beautiful scenery. If you guys get bored, go get some water, because I'm really thirsty, and come on back and check out this stuff in front of us. I mean, look at this. Look at that silhouette. That might have to be a thumbnail. Yeah, it's pretty nice. Yeah, baby. Oh, yeah. I should have stood up for that one. It's funny, sometimes I get so lazy. I just ride it out. You know, I haven't looked at the GPS in quite a while. I wonder if I'm, I do that sometimes and find out that I'm, you know, like 20, not 20 miles, but a couple of miles off the route. Oh, boy, I would hate to have that happen. I'd have to blame you guys for making me talk like this. So there's that 128, so I definitely want to camp before I get to that. So we got a hill climb over there, go through some water. So you guys hang in there. I won't turn it off. If you guys don't go away, I won't turn it off. You guys leave, and that's it, man. I'm turning it off. It's pretty steep here. Like I say, it doesn't look like it. Where are we going? This is interesting. Ah, look at that. Guys, this is just gorgeous. We gotta stop and look at this. Wow, my gosh. Look up there. Crazy, crazy cool. Oh, we're gonna go through. You guys can't go anywhere. No, you're not allowed to, because look where we're going. We're going to go through that slot canyon thing. That's just gorgeous.